Now, Helen Burns is another key character that plays a very formative role in Jane's early years, especially when she reaches Lowood School. Now, when Jane Eyre reaches Lowood School, she's full of vengeance. She's very angry at how mistreated she has been in the hands of the Reed family, and she strongly believes that an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. In other words, she strongly believes in seeking vengeance when wronged. However, Helen Burns really teaches her in school, in Lowood School, when she meets her, the powerful Christian virtues of forgiveness, perseverance, and of course being the quintessential passive Victorian woman who endures. It's her duty to endure, even if life really hits her. God will reward her in the end for enduring and not and turning the other cheek, as opposed to fighting back and striking out. So Helen Burns has a very indelible mark on Jane Eyre, and hence why she's such an important character to remember key quotations for. Now, the first quotation to remember when it comes to Helen Burns' character is when she advises Jane the following. She says, "It is far better to endure a smart ellipsis than to commit a hasty action." A smart meaning, you know, it's far better to endure bad treatment or someone who has hit you or said something that hurts you. Endure, forgive them, rather than lash back out. And of course, here, Helen Burns is basically responding when Jane Eyre asks her, how are you able to really keep your cool when you're being hit by the teachers, when you've done really nothing from my perspective, when you're being mistreated? And she says, it's far better to just forgive yourself. When you forgive and you exercise these Christian virtues, that enables you to become a better person. Now, the word level analysis you want to do for this quotation is firstly the comparative adjective better, and of course the adverb hasty, this idea of enduring, the dutiful Christian woman, and these virtues are being taught to Jane, and Jane does eventually learn these virtues and she proceeds to take them on as she grows older and becomes a governor. Now, the next one, and when I said governor, I meant governess. Now, the next quotation to remember when it comes to Helen Burns' character is when Jane watches how she is treated and how she is hit. However, she describes her demeanor. She is very, very powerful and enduring. It states, composed, though grave she stood. Now, here, she's very, very controlled. Her passions are controlled. This is Helen Burns. Even when she's being cursed at by her teachers, even when she's being punished, she composes herself, and Jane Eyre really wants to emulate these virtues. Now, the word level analysis you want to do for this quotation is the sibilance. Of course, this is part of alliteration, she and stood, and of course this is emphasizing just the admiration, the pure, sheer and utter admiration that Jane Eyre has for the strength of character that Helen Burns has. The other quotation and word level analysis you want to do is when Jane Eyre describes how Helen Burns, she lifted her eyes, ellipsis, a martyr, a hero. And again, here, this shows how she sees Helen Burns almost as this messianic figure. She's teaching Jane Eyre the really powerful Christian virtues of endurance and forgiveness. Now, here, the word level analysis you want to do is, of course, the listing of martyr and hero, and this is hyperbole. She's being described in very religious terminology, okay? And the final quotation in relation to Helen Burns' character is when she tells Jane and she admonishes her and tells her, stop seeking revenge, stop being so angry. She tells her, you're too impulsive, too vehement. And here, you want to focus on the repetition of the intensifiers too. Here, she's telling Jane off and she's telling her, you need to learn how to control your emotions, to temper them and to stop being so angry, and actually always opt for forgiveness. So that's it when it comes to remembering key quotations for the character of Helen Burns. Thank you.